Hello student, welcome to your chemistry lab. Today I am discussing Hobman-Bomide reaction or Hobman degradation reaction, or that is Hobman rearrangement reaction. It is important for JE, NEET and also for board. So read very carefully. Now watching the whiteboard. Hobman degradation or Hobman-Bomide reaction. Acid amide react with Br2 in presence of alkali, that is NOH or KOH, at about 70 degree centigrade to give primary amine. This is the reaction, that is RCONH2 react with Br2 KOH gives RNH2, that is primary amine. The amine form has a carbon atom less than the parent acid amide. The reaction also occurred in presence of sodium or potassium hypobromide, that is NaOBr or KOBr. CH3CONH2, that is acid amide, react with Br2 KOH gives CH3NH2, that is primary amine, gives KBr, gives K2CO3 plus H2. Second example, that is C6H5CONH2, that is benzamide, react with Br2 KOH gives C6H5NH2, that is aniline. Now discuss the reaction of Hobman-Bomide reaction with mechanism, means mechanism of Hobman-Bomide or Hobman degradation reaction. RCONH2 plus Br2 plus NOH plus H2O gives RNH2 plus 2NaBr plus Na2CO3 plus 2H2O. From this equation, we can see that the carbonyl carbon atom of the amide is lost, that is CO32 negative, and that the R group, that is the alkyl group of the amide, becomes attached to the nitrogen of the amine. Primary amines made this way are not contaminated by 2 degree or 3 degree amines. That is, we can prepare only primary amine, not 2 degree and 3 degree amines. The mechanism for this interesting reaction is shown in the following scheme. The first two steps, the amide undergo a base protonated bromination in a manner analogous to the base protonated halogenation of a ketone, that the electron withdrawing acyl group of the amide makes the amido hydrogen much more acidic than those of an amine. The N-bromoamide then react with hydroxide ion to produce an anion, which simultaneously rearrange with the loss of a bromide ion to produce an isocyanate. Now let's discuss with reaction. RCONH2, that is the amide base, remove proton from amide gives this RCONH, that is the anion. This anion react with Br from N-bromoamide. This is the base protonated N-bromination of the amide occur. Next, OH negative, that is base, remove a proton from N-bromoamide gives bromoamide ion. And the R group migrates to the nitrogen. A bromide ion departs. This process is an isocyanate. Means here bromine is removed and R group is migrate from isocyanate. In the rearrangement, the R group migrates with its electron from the acyl carbon to the nitrogen atom at the same time the bromide ion departs. And the isocyanate that's occurred, a mixture is quickly hydrolyzed by aqueous base to the carbamate ion, which undergo spontaneous decarboxylation resulting in the formation of the amine. Now let's discuss with reaction. RNC double bond O, that is isocyanide, react with base that is OH negative, form this carbamate ion, that is RNCOOH, and this carbamate ion is stabilized through resonance and rearranged from this product, that is transfer of proton lead to the carbamate ion, and hydrolysis gives the primary amine, that is RNH2 and CO2H2O, and form HCO3 negative. And here the isocyanate undergo hydrolysis and decarboxylation to produce primary amine. Problem: in the set of reaction, propanoic acid yielded a compound C. CH3CH2COOH-SOCl2 gives A, NH3 gives B, Br2KOH gives C. Answer: CH3CH2COOH, that is propanoic acid, react with SOCl2 gives propanoyl chloride, that is A, and NH3 react with propanoyl chloride gives B, that is propanamide, and react with Br2KOH gives C, that is ethyl amine. I think you are enjoying to watch my video. I hope you are understanding all the points. If are not clear, so comment me. I will be replying. If are you need to discuss any topics, please comment me. I will be discussing for you, and stay with your chemistry.